नारद जी व्यास जी को उपदेश देकर वहां से चले गए। तब व्यास जी अपने आश्रम में समाधि योग लगाया और उसमें अपश्यत पुरुषम पूर्ण पूर्ण पुरुष को देखा। माने क्या? कृष्ण को देखा। वहां के जितने परिकर नंद बाबा यशोदा मैया को देखा, सखाओं को देखा, गोपियों को देखा, रासस्थली देखा, रास में उनका जितना गोपियों के साथ में जैसे जैसे नृत्य किया था, सब लीलाओं को उन्होंने दर्शन किया। और दर्शन करने के बाद में ये भी देखा, जीव जो भगवान का नित्य दास है, भगवान का अणु है, स्थानीय है, वो भगवान को भूल करके यद्यपि माया से परे है, चिन्मय है, सच्चिदानंदमय है आंशिक रूप में, किंतु अपने को माया का वशीभूत समझकर ये शरीर मैं हूं, ये हमारे कुटुंबी है, धन है हमारा, सब कुछ है, इस प्रकार से मोहित होकर संसार में भटक रहा है। और अनर्थोपशमम साक्षात भक्ति योगम अधोखजे लोकस्य अजानतो विद्वान चक्रे संदिता। और फिर समाधि में जो कुछ देखा था ठीक वैसे ही जो लोग ये तत्व नहीं जानते हैं उन लोगों को जानने के लिए, बतलाने के लिए इस श्रीमद् भागवत की रचना की। रचना व्यास जी ने नहीं की, निर्माण नहीं किया, जैसा देखा था वैसे ही लिखा। ये लीला नित्य है, पहले नहीं थी अब हुई ऐसा नहीं, पहले से ही वो लीला है। उन्होंने देखा और उसको लिपिबद्ध किया, जैसा देखा था वैसा किया। जैसे वाई सुयमायण कृष्णे परम पुरुषे भक्ति रूप पद्धति पुंस शोक मोह भया। जिसके सुनने से परम पुरुष जो श्री कृष्ण में, उनके प्रति चरणों में अहेतु की भक्ति अवश्य ही हो जाती है, निश्चित रूप में हो जाती है, उनका शोक मोह भय डर सब कुछ दूर हो जाता है, आत्मा प्रसन्न हो जाती है। और फिर रचना करके देखा, जे भाई अब किसको पढ़ाएं, जगत में योग्य कौन है जो इसको ग्रहण कर सके, जो संसार से पूर्ण रूप से निवृत्त है, जिसको अब संसार वासना कोई कामना नहीं है, और ऐसा योग्य जो हमारे बातों को समझ सके, उसको ये पढ़ाऊंगा। उस समय में व्यास जी ने सोच करके जंगल में चले गए थे और कहां पुत्र हमारा है, खोज रहे थे। कुछ सुख पक्षी बजाने वाले बहेलिए जा रहे थे जंगल में सुख पकड़ने के लिए, पक्षी पकड़ने के लिए। तो पूछा जे कहां जा रहे हो, तो जंगल में किस लिए, पक्षियों को पकड़ करके हम बेच देते हैं जीविका निर्वाह। अच्छा मैं तुमको एक मंत्र बतलाता हूं, उस मंत्र को करने से तुम्हारे जाल में बहुत से पक्षी आ जाएंगे। तब उन्होंने कहा ये मंत्र जपना, बरहा पीड़म नटवर बपु कर्णयो कर्णिकारम बृहद बासम कनक कपिशम भय जयंती चिमाला रंदन प्रेणुर अदर सुधया पूर्यन गोप बिंदई बिंदारण्यम सपदर्पणम पापिश। उन्होंने मुखस्त कर लिया और जंगल में जाकर के बोलने लगे, सचमुच में आज बहुत से पक्षी के साथ साथ में एक सुख पक्षी भी आ गया वहां, वही सुखदेव गोस्वामी। वो सुखदेव गोस्वामी ने पूछा ये तुमने श्लोक कहां से सुना, तो हमने अपने गुरु जी हैं हमारे व्यास जी, उनसे सुना, तो उनसे पूछ करके कल आना कि उनके गुण क्या हैं।
कितना सुंदर रूप उनका।
फिर गए दूसरे दिन, फिर उन लोगों ने पूछा तो व्यास जी ने कहा, ओहो बकियम स्तन काल कूटम जिघन से आपात लेवी गति तम धात उचितम। विष मिला करके अपने स्तन में मारने के लिए गई और उसको धात्री उचित गति दे दी। ओ ऐसे भगवान को छोड़ करके किसका हम भजन करेंगे। बैलिए गए, फिर ये श्लोक बोला और वो इतने आकृष्ट हुए, आत्मा रामस्य मुनयो उरुक्रमे कुर्वंत है तुकिं भक्तिं इत्थं भूत गुण है। ये तो ब्रह्म निष्ठा संपन्न थे, संसार से और भगवान से भी इनसे कोई संबंध कृष्ण से, कृष्ण लीलाओं से नहीं था। ओ निर्विशेष परब्रह्म में इनकी बड़ी निष्ठा थी, किंतु भगवान के गुण ही ऐसे हैं। व्यास जी ने जो वर्णन किया वो रह नहीं सके, झट उनके पास में आ गए। आप कृपा करके जहां जो ग्रंथ की रचना की है हमको पढ़ाइए। तब उनको सुखदेव गोस्वामी जी को उन्होंने पढ़ाया। तब सुखदेव गोस्वामी ने सारे विश्व में प्रचार करने के लिए इस भागवत कथा को सबसे पहले मुमूर्षु परीक्षित महाराज जी को सुनाया। इसके बाद में गोकर्ण ने सुनाया
धुंधुकारी को,
और इसके थोड़े वर्षों के बाद में सनत सनंदन सनत कुमार जी ने नारद के बहाने भक्ति देवी को सुनाया, जिससे कि उनके पुत्र ज्ञान वैराग्य भी नौजवान हो गए और भक्ति भी बड़ी प्रसन्न हो गई। हाँ, ट्रांसलेशन।
Therefore, hearing all the instructions of Sri Narad Muni, then Sri Vyasadeva returned to his ashram. And there he engaged his mind according to the instructions of Sri Narad Muni. Bhakti yoga na manasi samyak pranagi amari apasyat purusam purnam maya chatat apasyam. Yoyav samavito jivan atmanam trigunatmakam parate manit anatam chatkritam chabipadyate. What did Vyasadeva see? He saw two things. First, he saw the Purnam Purush, because God is a person. We are also persons, but God is the complete person. Then he saw that complete supreme person with his energy, that means Srimati Radhika, along with his associates like the gopis, Nanda Baba, Yasoda, along with the activities of that supreme lord like Ras Lila and all the other Lilas Vyasadeva saw in his trance of devotional yoga, bhakti yoga. And what else did he see? Yoyo samhavita jivam atmanam trigunatmakam. He saw that the individual soul, us, which is also a part of the Supreme Lord, a minute part, which is also transcendental, which is also composed of eternity, knowledge and bliss. But because of turning his face away from the Lord towards material enjoyment, he is captured by illusion and rotating in the cycle of birth, death, old age and disease. But he saw that if the jivas, the individual souls, turn their face again towards the service of the Lord, they can become liberated and eternally happy. Therefore, that in order that souls who have turned their face away from Krishna and who have come to this world, in order that such souls, like us, can turn again towards the service of Krishna, Vyasadeva, out of his unlimited mercy, compiled the Srimad Bhagavatam, Anathopasanam Sakshat Bhakti Yoga Doksaji. By hearing this same Bhagavatam that Gurudev is speaking, this is the same Bhagavatam compiled by Vyasadeva, by hearing Anathopasanam Sakshat, all other bad desires are destroyed and one is again taste the nectar of the service of the Supreme Lord. Therefore, how important is hearing? Don't think that Vyasadeva made this up or compiled. No, don't think that at all. What Vyasadeva saw in his meditation, he wrote only that, because the pastimes of the incarnations of the Supreme Lord are all eternal. They have no beginning and no end. Therefore, Yasya Vaisyamanayam. Whoever hears this Srimad Bhagavatam, then immediately devotional service to Krishna awakens within the heart. Therefore, Vyasadeva had many disciples, but he thought This Bhagavatam is so pure and spotless, to whom will I give this thing? Therefore he remembered. Remember the first day Gurudev came, he spoke about the history of Sukadev Goswami. So Gurudev tying all this together. He remembered, I have that one son, Sukadev Goswami. He is completely detached from material enjoyment. Therefore I will give this Bhagavatam to him and to him only. Therefore as Vyasadeva was moving, he saw one hunter, one bird catcher. And Vyasadeva asked him, where are you going? He said, I'm going to catch birds. Then I'll sell them in the market, like parrots, things like that. Then Vyasadeva said, I'll give you a special mantra. This mantra is so attractive, many birds will come in your net. So the hunter said, very good. Then Vyasadeva taught him one of these verses from the Bhagavatam, which is mantra. Parabhitam natabarabhapu kaneyo kanikaram vipradvasat kanakikapisam vajayantim chamaram, etc. Describing the beautiful form of Krishna. Therefore, as the hunter was chanting that mantra, many, many birds came, and also one big bird, that is Sukadev Goswami, now in human form. We heard that on the first day. He came and caught hold of that hunter. Such a nectarian mantra. Who is that person who has such a beautiful form? Then Sukadev Goswami said, where did you get this mantra from? I never heard such nectar. Then the hunter said, I got it from my Gurudev, Vyas. He said, then Sukadev Goswami said, you go back to your Gurudev and ask. That person who you're describing has such a wonderful form, but what are his qualities? Sometimes you see someone who's very beautiful, but they may be very cruel or selfish, therefore not so perfect. Therefore tell me, what are the qualities of that person whom you're describing? Then the hunter went back to Vyasadeva and told. Then Vyasadeva said, I'll give you another verse. Aho bakiyam stanakalu kutam jigamasi apiyasatvi. Levidatram gachata utatato anyam kovai saranam salanam brajema. Who is more kind than Krishna? When Krishna was a little baby, 7 days old, one witch came to poison him by putting poison on her breast to kill him. But Krishna was so merciful. He took the poison, took her life, and gave her a position in the spiritual world. Therefore, who is more merciful than Krishna? He liberates those who even come to kill him. What to speak of those who are chanting his name with love? Therefore, such wonderful qualities. Therefore, Sukadev Goswami became mad, intoxicated. And he went to Vyasadeva and fell at his feet. Please tell me about Krishna and the worship of Krishna. Therefore, there is a famous verse in the Bhagavatam. Atmaramas chamunayo nigrantibi urukrami kurvanti oitikim bhaktim itam bhuto gunohari. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave 64 explanations of this verse. What does it mean? That Krishna is so attractive. Itam bhuto gunohari. He has such wonderful qualities like beauty, compassion, pastimes, that he attracts the minds of even liberated souls. Therefore, this is proof. Sukadev Goswami was Brahmanishta. He was completely absorbed in Nirvishesh Brahm, like the big white light that everybody talks about. He was completely absorbed in that. He had no material attachment. But when he heard about the form of Krishna, the qualities of Krishna, the activities of Krishna, he gave that up and became a devotee of Krishna. Therefore, this same Vyasadeva, this same Srimad Bhagavatam, that Narada Muni gave to Vyas, then Vyas gave to Sukadev Goswami, then 5,000 years ago, again was spoken to Parikshit Maharaj. And this same we are getting a chance to hear from Gurudev. That same Bhagavatam was also spoken in the Padma Purana, you see Bhagavat Mahatmya. The same Bhagavat was spoken by the Chatusna, the four Kumaras, to Narada. And also
as excuse of Narada, he taught to Devi and Gyan Vaidagya.
Also Dundak, what's his name? Dundakari to Gokarna to Dundakari. The same Bhagavatam. Therefore, this is an unbroken chain of Srimad Bhagavatam descending from that time even to this present day. Srimad Bhagavat ki. Yeah.
श्रीमद् भागवत के अंत में व्यास जी ने स्वयं ही लिखा है श्रीमद् भागवतम पुराण अमलम जद वैष्णवानाम प्रियम। श्रीमद् भागवत वैष्णवों का प्रिय ग्रंथ है, अद्वैतवादियों का, मायावादियों का नहीं है। किंतु आजकल गीता प्रेस से जो भागवत निकलती है उसका जो अर्थ है उसके करने वाले अखंडानंद सरस्वती महामायावादी और अद्वैतवादी थे। उन्होंने इसका उल्टा अर्थ करके, जो नहीं होना चाहिए वो सब अर्थ करके, उन्होंने कहा जो भागवत का तात्पर्य है ब्रह्म में सायुज मुक्ति। वैष्णव लोग तो दीयमानोपि न गृह्णन्ति बिना मत सेवनं जना। वैष्णव लोग तो भगवान कहते हैं कि हमारी मुक्ति ले लो पांच प्रकार की, और वो कहते हैं कि नहीं 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 नहीं,
आंख बंद कर देखिए,
आंख बंद करके घृणा लगती है, नहीं लेते हैं। किंतु अखंडानंद सरस्वती इत्यादि अद्वैतवादियों ने गीता प्रेस की ये पुस्तक के द्वारा सारे विश्व में मायावाद का प्रचार किया, किंतु यह बात ठीक नहीं है। आप लोग समझ रखिए, गीता का भागवत का तात्पर्य भक्ति से है, कभी भी सायुज मुक्ति या किसी भी मुक्ति नहीं है, उसका खंडन किया है। श्रेयसितिम भक्ति मुदस्यते विभो क्लिशे अंत जे का वो तो व्यर्थ। भूसी के कूटने के समय चावल का कण पाने के लिए यदि भूसी को, थोथी भूसी को यदि लाख वर्ष तक कूटिए कुछ नहीं मिलेगा, ऐसे व्यर्थ परिश्रम है। इसलिए आप लोग समझ रखिए जो भागवत का तात्पर्य भक्ति है, मैं ब्रह्म नहीं हूं ब्रह्म का सेवक हूं ये समझिए। कृष्ण, कृष्ण की लीला, कृष्ण का नाम गुण लीला, ये सब अप्राकृत और नित्य है, भगवान की सेवा नित्य है। इसलिए वैष्णव का ग्रंथ है, इसमें पढ़ने से भगवान की सेवा होगी, भक्ति होगी। जस्या वही श्रूयमाणायाम कृष्ण परम पुरुषे भक्ति रूप पद्यते पुंस शोक मोह भया, ये ऐसी भक्ति होती है। ये भक्ति भी, अच्छा ट्रांसलेशन करो,
therefore in the end of Srimad Bhagavatam Vyasadeva has said himself, Srimad Bhagavatam Puram Namalam Yad Vaishnavanam Priyam Yad Paramahams Ekamavaram Param Gyanam Giyate, etc. Vyasadeva himself has described this Srimad Bhagavatam. He said, Srimad Bhagavatam Puranam Amalam Yad Vaishnavanam Priyam. This Bhagavatam is the spotless Purana because there's no touch of material anything there. And Yad Vaishnavanam Priyam, it's very dear to the Vaishnavas, the devotees of Krishna. Therefore, but an astonishing thing is that nowadays, okay, in India there's a very cheap publishing company called Gita Press, and their one good thing, they print books very cheaply, but their bad thing is they give completely wrong explanations of most of it. Therefore, the Srimad Bhagavatam has been, one commentary has been written there by one Akananda Saraswati, and there he has said the goal of the Bhagavatam is to merge with God, merge with Krishna. This is called Sayuja Mukti. But this is completely ridiculous because Sukadeva Goswami, he already gave up Sayuja Mukti to become a devotee, and then he's going to go back to it. Therefore, even if these five types of liberation are given to the devotees, Diyamanam Matkriyanam Binamat Sevanam Janam, even if the Lord himself offers five types of liberation, including Sayuja Mukti, Brahmalin, the devotee hates it. Grina means they close their eyes, they don't even look towards it. Therefore, Sayuja Mukti or merging with God has been completely rejected in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Therefore, these people are giving the wrong explanation of the Bhagavatam. Therefore, the conclusion in the beginning, the middle, and the end of the Bhagavatam, there is only one thing, service to God, service to Krishna or Bhakti Yoga. We see so many times in the Bhagavatam that the idea of merging with Krishna is completely rejectable. Because if you merge with Krishna, you cannot do his service. Therefore, Lord Brahma has said, that person who gives up the process of bhakti for any other process is like a person who pounds rice bran, the husk of rice, to get some grains. Means hard work, but no benefit at all. Therefore, we are not God, we are not Brahma. What are we? We are servants of God, servants of Parabrahma. Therefore, Krishna's name, form, qualities, and activities are all eternal, and this Srimad Bhagavatam has described only that service to Sri Krishna. There is no other conclusion.
Bhakti ke tartamya se भक्त भी पांच प्रकार के होते हैं. जिसके हृदय में जैसी जहां तक भक्ति है उसी के अनुसार में वो भक्त है. भक्त एक ही प्रकार का नहीं होता, उनकी कैटेगरी लाखों की है. किंतु उनमें से सबको छांट कर पांच प्रकार के माना है. पहला है ज्ञानी भक्त, दूसरा है शुद्ध भक्त, तीसरा प्रेमी भक्त, चौथा
प्रेम
पर भक्त, और पांचवा है प्रेमातुर. अब इसको समझिए. पहला है ज्ञानी भक्त. ज्ञान में और ज्ञानी भक्त में बहुत अंतर है. ज्ञानी है वह जो अपने को ब्रह्म मानता है और उसमें शारीरिक मुक्ति चाहता है, वो ज्ञानी है. और ज्ञानी भक्त भगवान के समस्त तत्व को जानकर, कृष्ण तत्व, जीव तत्व, माया तत्व और कृष्ण राधा तत्व, रस तत्व, ये सब तत्वों को जो जान करके और भक्ति करता है वो ज्ञानी भक्त है. जैसे प्रह्लाद महाराज, जैसे प्रथम जीवन में सुखदेव गोस्वामी, द्वितीय जीवन में, पहले वो भी निर्विशेषवादी, अद्वैतवादी नहीं, निर्विशेषवादी नहीं, ब्रह्मवादी थे. ब्रह्मवाद में और अद्वैत गायन में बहुत अंतर है. तो वो ब्रह्मज्ञाननिष्ठ थे, ब्रह्मनिष्ठ. और ना और कौन, सनक सनंदन सनातन, ये लोग भी ब्रह्मनिष्ठ थे. ब्रह्मा की कृपा से नारायण लोक में जाकर के नारायण के चरणों में दी हुई तुलसी का मकरंद उनके कान नाकों में गया और तब वो भी बिक गए भगवान के चरणों में. इसलिए भक्ति ही सर्वश्रेष्ठ है. तो मैं क्या कह रहा था,
ज्ञानी भक्त
वह है जो भगवान के तत्व को जानने वाला है और अपने इष्ट देव को, प्रभु को सर्वव्यापी समझकर सब जीवों के हृदय में देखता है और जीवों के हृदय में भगवान को देखता है. अपने और सब जीवों के हृदय में भगवान को देखता है, अपने इष्ट देव को, और इष्ट देव में सबको देखता है. ये महाभागवत प्रह्लाद महाराज जी जैसे ज्ञानी भक्त हैं. कैसे हैं, संक्षेप में हम लोग थोड़ा सा वर्णन करेंगे. मैं तो कृष्ण का की लीलाओं को वर्णन करना चाहता था, किंतु यह जानना आवश्यक है, नहीं तो भक्ति नहीं होगी. इसलिए इनके चरित्रों को भी कहना अत्यंत आवश्यक है. इसलिए हमारे पद्मनाभ महाराज जी संक्षेप में उनका बाल चरित्र प्रह्लाद महाराज जी का बतलाइए.
So Gurudev says that he has a great desire to speak the pastimes of Krishna, but unless we understand some things first, then we will not understand the activities of Krishna. So even though that there are great, all types of devotees are not the same, and their absorption is also not the same. There are millions and millions of different levels of devotees and devotion. But in a very simplified form, we can say there are five types of devotees: Jnani Bhakta, Sudha Bhakta, Premi Bhakta, Prema Par Bhakta, and Prem Atur. First, what is Jnani Bhakta? We should understand there is a great difference between a Jnani and a Jnani Bhakta. A Jnani are those who accept themselves as Brahma. as spiritual essence, and their goal is to become one with God. They are called Gyanis. But quite different from them are the Gyani Bhaktas. The Gyani Bhaktas, they know Krishna, and they know everything related to Krishna. His names, forms, qualities, pastimes, his energies, his different abodes, they know everything. And knowing everything, they engage themselves in the service of the Lord. They are called Gyani Bhaktas. Therefore, there's two completely different things, Gyani and Gyani Bhakta. What's an example of a Gyani Bhakta? A Gyani Bhakta is like Prahlad Maharaj, or like Sri Sukadev Goswami in his second stage. At first, Sri Sukadev Goswami was a Brahmavadi, but he was not an Advaitivadi. Brahmavadi and Advaitivadi is a very, very different thing. But Gurudev will explain after. Brahmavadi means they have Nishtha in Brahma. They accept Bhagawan's form, but they are more attracted to the impersonal aspect. But Advaitavadis, they do not accept the form of Bhagawan. Therefore, there is a huge difference between a Brahmavadi and an Advaitavadi. Brahmavadis like Sukadev Goswami, if they get association with a devotee, they can easily become devotees. There was Sukadev Goswami in his second stage. He knows all tattva, everything about Krishna, and engages in his service. Also like the mental born sons of Lord Brahma, they are called the four Kumara or the Chatusna. Before, they were also Brahmavadis. But their father and guru, Lord Brahma, by his inspiration, they went to the spiritual world, Vaikuntha. And as they went, Lord Narayana, say Krishna to make it easy, Lord Krishna came outside. That time they smelt the tulsi leaves mixed with sandalwood on the feet of Krishna. And that smell went in their nose, they changed and became attracted to devotion. Therefore, they are also known as Gyani Bhaktas. What is their symptom? They see their worshipful Lord everywhere and everything in Him. Means in Him they see all jivas. In the hearts of all jivas they see only Him. And in His heart they see everything. Everything is in Him and He is in everything. Now, everywhere they look and everything they see nothing else except the Supreme Lord. Such a person is called a Gyani Bhakta. Therefore, an example of Gyani Bhakta is Prahlad Maharaj. And now Pujapad Padmanabha will describe something, the childhood pastimes of the childhood teachings of Prahlad Maharaj.
Om Agyanat Mirandasya Gyanam Janashalakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. So, Srila Gurudev is teaching us the different levels of bhaktas, which are indicated in the Srimad Bhagavatam, specifically five levels of bhaktas. So he has ordered me to tell in very brief the charitra, the character and history of Sri Prahlad Maharaj from the seventh canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So we have heard from Srimad Bhagavatam that Prahlad Maharaj, he was the son of a very great demon. This demon was named Hiranyakashipu. So Hiranyakashipu, he wanted to get revenge against Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, because in another place in Srimad Bhagavatam it describes that Lord Vishnu had come in the form of Lord Varahadev and had killed his brother named Hiranyaksha. So Hiranyakashipu was also a very great materialistic person. So he went and did very severe austerities. And these severe austerities are vividly described in Srimad Bhagavatam, that he stood on the tips of his toes, and for thousands of years he was performing this very hard austerity. Even the ants had eaten his bodily flesh and muscle, only his skeleton and bones were remaining, and anthills were built all around him. So when he had completed his austerities, then Lord Brahma came. Lord Brahma, the creator of this universe, he is not the Supreme Lord. He is a demigod who is empowered by the Supreme Lord to create this universe. But that was the aim and object of Hiranyakashipu, that Lord Brahma would award him any of his desires. He would fulfill any of his desires as a reward for his severe austerity. So when Lord Brahma came and he saw what kind of austerity he had done, only his skeleton was remaining, and he was so powerful that even he could keep his life airs, his pran, within the bones of his body. So now Lord Brahma came there on his swan carrier, and from his kamandalu, he poured some droplets of nectar on the head of Hiranyakashipu. Now immediately Hiranyakashipu was restored to a very powerful body, like a thunderbolt, very young, beautiful and powerful. And immediately Hiranyakashipu saw Lord Brahma and he paid his obeisances to him. So Lord Brahma now inquired from him, what kind of benediction would you like? And Hiranyakashipu, he told to Lord Brahma, I want to become immortal, that I will never have to die. So then Lord Brahma told him, he said, actually, I cannot give you that benediction because even I myself must die. So how can I give you the benediction of immortality? So then Hiranyakashipu, he thought of some other benedictions. He said, okay, then at least award me that I will not die in the day or in the night time. And the Lord Brahma said, okay, I can give you that benediction. You will not die in the day or the night. Then he said, give me the benediction that I will not die on the land, on the water, or in the air. Yes, I can give you that benediction. Give me the benediction that I will not die by any being created by you within this universe, man or animal or beast or anything. Yes, I can give you that benediction. Give me the benediction that I cannot be killed by any weapon, any type of weapon, man-made weapon. Yes, I can give you that benediction. And in this way, Hiranyakashipu received the sanction that he would not die in any of these ways. And then he calculated, oh, okay, now I have become immortal. And he raised his arms and loudly declared his immortality. So it so happened that during the same time, the queen of Hiranyakashipu, because the demigods were realizing that this demon will become very powerful, and in the womb of the wife of Hiranyakashipu was a baby. So they thought, this baby, this child of Hiranyakashipu, will become a great demon just like him. Better that we kidnap her and that we should kill the baby in the womb before he disturbs the whole universe. So then as they were carrying away the wife of Hiranyakashipu, Narad Muni came. And Narad Muni stopped the demigods and he told them, no, you don't understand. In the womb of this woman, there is a very great devotee actually. So then he took that lady to his ashram. And there, Sri Naradaji, he began to speak the glories of Sri Krishna, just like we have heard today, how he instructed Srila Vyasadeva. So Narada Muni himself spoke all these transcendental glories of Srimad Bhagavatam and so forth, all the pastimes of Krishna. So in the womb, the child was hearing. So when the child was born, that child was actually a pure devotee named Prahlad Maharaj. So Hiranyakashipu, after receiving this power, he began to terrorize the whole universe. And he was so powerful that even he was able to defeat all the demigods, including Lord Indra. And he took over even the throne of the King of Heaven, Lord Indra, and he sat on that throne. And from that position, he was so powerful, he was even controlling the movements of the sun and the time factor. And even karma, it is described, he was controlling the karma of the living entities. So in this way, Hiranyakashipu, although very, very demoniac, he now thought that he was immortal and all-powerful. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes that when Prahlad Maharaj was a young boy, very small, like 5 years old, then his father sent him to school with the other royal young children. And when his son came back from school on the first day, then he came to the lap of his father. And his father became overwhelmed with affection to see his young, beautiful child all decorated nicely by his mother. And now he lifted his child onto his lap And he began to smell the head of his child with affection. And he looked at his child's face and he said, "Oh, my dear son, please, now, please tell me, what do you think is the very best thing that you have learned from your teachers?" And then Prahlad Maharaj, he looked at his father and he said, "Oh," he didn't call him "my dear father." He said, "Oh, best of the demons. Huh? Best of the asuras, tatsadaman ye asuravaryam dehinam, sadasa mudvigna diya asadgrahat, hitvatma patam grihamandakupam, gato varam yad harimashrayeta." So, Prahlad Maharaj gave a very powerful instruction to his father. He said, "Oh my dear father, you asked me what is the best thing. I think that the very best thing is that those persons who have constantly been absorbed in this deep dark well of household life in this material world, sada samud vigna diya asad grahat, they have accepted this temporary situation of life as being eternal and permanent. And therefore, they're constantly filled with all kinds of anxieties. They have fallen into this very undakupam, this dark well of material existence. So I think the best thing is that they should immediately give this up. Hitvatma patam griham andakupam. They should give up this dark well immediately. And vanam gato yad tarim ashrayeta. They should go to the forest and take full shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari." Oh, when Hiranyakashipu heard this, oh, he was completely startled that his son would come out with such a thing, glorifying his enemy, Hari, Lord Vishnu. But actually, Prahlad Maharaj, he was giving a very important teaching, because the purport of what Prahlad Maharaj told, there's a very nice description to give us a clear understanding of what he was teaching, what he was trying to tell to his father. And the story goes that once there was a person who was walking through a forest. So, as he was walking through this forest, suddenly he heard a very loud sound. And he turned and he looked, and he saw there was a tiger with gaping jaws staring right at him. So what did he do? Immediately, he began to run as fast as he possibly could, and he was running, and now the tiger began to run after him also. And he ran and ran. And everywhere he was looking, "Where can I get away from this tiger? Where can I find shelter?" Suddenly, he looked and he saw that there was a well that was somewhat covered with some grasses. So, and there was a tree hanging over the well that a couple of branches were hanging down. So he grabbed a hold of those two branches of the tree with his two arms, and he lowered himself down into the well. And now, when he was hanging there, holding onto the branches, he looked upwards and he saw the tiger's mouth again looking down at him, growling. Rawr. And then he looked below him, and then he saw that there were snakes hissing. Sss, and they were trying to also bite him from below. And now he realized, "Oh my God, what will I do now?" So, then, to make things even a little bit worse, it couldn't get much worse than this, but it does. So he's holding on to these two branches, and he looks up and he sees that on each branch there's two rats, and they're chewing on the branch. One rat is white, one rat is black. So he's now lost all hope practically at all, but still he's holding on for dear life. And then he notices one thing. Just up above him, there's a beehive. And this beehive has some honey that's dripping down out of it, and the dripping of that honey is falling just in front of his face, a couple of inches forward in front of his face. So what does he do? He thinks, "Oh, very good." He stretches out, he tries to lean his head forward, and he puts out his tongue as far as he can, and he catches a couple of drops of honey on his tongue. And then he thinks, "Oh, how sweet." But did the tiger disappear? No. Did the snakes disappear? No. Did the rats stop biting? No. So what is the purport of this story? who is this person running through the forest? Can anyone tell me? Who is that person? It's you and me. Every one of us in this material world are exactly like this man. Why? Because who is the tiger? The tiger is impending death. Is there anyone in this room who is not facing impending death? You can raise your hand if there is someone here. No courage, huh? And so, impending death is definitely there for every single person who has been born. And Krishna, Lord Sri Krishna says in Gita, for one who is born, death is certain. So therefore, and below us, while we're going through this life, facing death at any single moment, we don't know when, below us there are these snakes. What are the snakes representing? The snakes are representing all the miseries of material existence constantly biting you and old age creeping up on you at any moment. And above, you're holding on to these branches. What is the branches? Your duration of life. No one knows how long. Could be 10 years, could be 50, could be 90. But no one knows, no one guaranteed how long. So then he's holding on to the branches. But we see that the branches are also gradually, bit by bit, being eaten away by two rats. What are those two rats? One is white, one is black. That represents the day and the night. Every day, every night, every day, every night, your duration of life is going away, never to return. But yet, in that condition of life, what are we doing, just like this man, who is in such a horrifying condition of life? He sees a little bit of honey, and he thinks, oh, let me taste that honey. And he forgets for that moment. By tasting a few drops of honey, a little bit of sweetness, he forgets his horrifying condition of life. And he thinks, oh, how nice, how sweet. What is that honey? That honey is all the affection that we're getting from our loved ones, from our family members, our husband, wife, children. And we forget, thinking that this danger will not come upon us, that death will not come. And we put all our hopes, all of our trust in the protection of these loved ones. So like this, Prahlad Maharaj instructed his father, Hiranyakashipu, that a person who is really, really intelligent, hitvatma patam griham andakupam, he should give up this ignorant state of life where one is blinded by materialistic desires. And he should take shelter of Lord Hari. That means he should perform the process of pure Shuddha Bhakti. So when Hiranyakashipu heard this from his son, he became very upset. But he told to his teachers, he said, oh, just see how the enemy sometimes tries to infiltrate and tries to contaminate the minds of the young ones. Oh, now you should take him to school and you should guard him much more carefully, much more carefully. So the two teachers took him away to school. The two teachers' names were Shanda and Amarika. And these two teachers now, they try to teach Prahlad Maharaj all sociology and politics and all the normal topics that a son in a royal demonic family should learn. How to rule, how to govern, how to defeat enemies, etc. So after some time, again one day, the teachers, Prahlad Maharaj's mother brought... Oh,
thank you. यहीं तक हरि कथा का विश्राम हम लोग देते हैं कल प्रहलाद महाराज जी का चरित्र और उसके बाद में जैसा जैसा हमने भक्ति का स्तर बतलाया है उसी तरह से हम लोग वर्णन करेंगे कुछ लोग यदि श्रीमद् भागवत को सप्ताह सुनते हैं यदि कोई व्यक्ति एक श्लोक भी रोज पाठ करे तो वो जन्म मरण से मुक्त हो जाएगा यदि कोई व्यक्ति आधा श्लोक भी उसका आधा एक पाद भी यदि करे तो भी उसको भक्ति होगी किंतु सात दिन में भागवत की कथा का प्राचलन चला हुआ है इससे श्रेष्ठ एक महीने वाला है एक महीने में जो भागवत का पाठ किया जाता है और उससे श्रेष्ठ है एक वर्ष में, और उससे भी श्रेष्ठ है जो हम लोग कह रहे हैं ये जीवन भर में समाप्त नहीं होगा, ये सब समय चलता रहेगा। इसलिए हम लोग तत्व को उघाड़ कर एक एक करके बतलाते हैं जिससे कि उनके हृदय में जल्दी से भक्ति प्रतिष्ठित हो जाए। इसलिए हमारी भागवत की कथा अभी शेष नहीं होगी, दो दिन के बाद में यहाँ प्रवचन समाप्त हो जाने के बाद में फिर जब हम आएंगे इसके बाद से फिर हम आरंभ करेंगे।
इसके बाद फिजी शुरू होगा, फिजी के बाद ऑस्ट्रेलिया शुरू होगा।
इस तरह से हरि कथा चलते रहेगी। गौर प्रेमानंदे महामंत्र हरे कृष्ण।
ट्रांसलेशन अनुवाद।
So, in India there's a thing called Bhagavat Saptaha, means hearing for 7 days. If one can do that, one will get bhakti. But if one cannot do that and one can only speak one verse every day, he'll get bhakti also. If you cannot even speak one whole verse, if you can only do half a verse or even one syllable properly, then you'll achieve devotion. Therefore, the real Bhagavatam is spoken in 7 days. But superior to that is 30 days continuous hearing. And superior to that is a 1 year continuous hearing of Bhagavatam. But Gurudev said the Bhagavatam we do is better than all of them because ours is continuous, it never stops. Therefore, if one can hear Bhagavatam continuously from the proper person, then bhakti will definitely enter the heart. So even though we're finishing our Harikatha today, Harikatha is actually never finished. Go Premanande!
Oh, Mahamantra.
Oh, after this program, as Srila Gurudev leaves to go out, after this there will be Artik and very wonderful Mahaprasadam feast for all, so everyone should stay and take Mahaprasadam. Gaur Premanande, Srila Gurudev ki jai, Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Samveda Bhakta Vrinda ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare